subcontinent has a coastline of over 8,000 kilometers and an exclusive economic zone of over 2 million square kilometers. The country is also endowed with a vast expanse of inland open water fishery resources, which includes 45,000 kilometers of river systems, 2.7 million hectares of estuarine areas, and an expanding resource of reservoirs, now accounting for 3.15 million hectares. Fish and fishery products are among the largest foreign exchange earners for the country. Fishing is a major source of food and provides employment and economic benefits to large sections of society in India. Variety of fishing gears and practices, ranging from artisanal to large-scale industrial systems, are used for fish capture. Traditional fishing gears used earlier were found to be relatively less productive. Traditional fishing nets are made of natural fibers such as cotton, manila, sisal, jute, and coir. As these materials are vulnerable to biodegradation, they have relatively short service lives and incur high maintenance costs due to frequent repairs. However, over the years, traditional fishing gears have given way to improved, more efficient fishing systems. The Central Institute of Fisheries Technology, known as SIFT, under the Indian Council of Agricultural Research, situated in Cochin, is the premier research and development organization dealing with the entire spectrum of harvest and post-harvest technology of fish. The institute has played a pivotal role in the upgrading and modernization of fishing nets operated in India. Synthetic fibers were introduced in India in the late 1950s. These products have mostly replaced the natural fibers used in traditional fishing gear. Synthetic fibers have high breaking strength, high resistance to weathering, low maintenance cost, long service life, and better uniformity in characteristics. The most important synthetic fibers used in fisheries are polyethylene, polyamide, polypropylene, and polyester. Other synthetic fibers, which are less widely used, are polyvinyl alcohol, polyvinyl chloride, and polyvinyl lidine chloride. Earlier, netting used to be fabricated by hand, which was a laborious and time-consuming process. In recent years, machine-made netting is almost exclusively used in fishing net fabrication. We'll be right back. fishing nets vary in their structure, materials used, principles of capture, and methods of operation. A sea net is a long wall of netting supported by floats and sinkers. Sea nets are operated by surrounding areas of water with potential catch. They are usually operated in the coastal or shallow waters where the sea bottom or surface acts as a natural barrier. Surrounding nets are roughly rectangular walls of netting rigged with floats and sinkers. After the detection of the presence of fish, the net is cast to encircle the fish school. Surrounding nets are generally operated on the surface layers of water bodies. Purse seines are the predominant type of surrounding nets. In a purse seine, the bottom of the net is closed after encircling the fish school by a purse line. Mini purse seine or ring seine used in the traditional motorized sector belong to this category of surrounding nets. Trawl nets are conical bag nets with two wings and a coat end where the catch is concentrated. Trawl nets are operated by towing the nets from one or two boats. Based on the position in the water column where they are operated, trawls are classified into midwater trawls and bottom trawls. Gill nets are rectangular walls of netting kept erect in water by means of floats and sinkers and positioned in the swimming layer of the target fish. They catch the fish by holding them in the mesh by gilling. There is no universal fishing gear suitable for all fishing conditions and resources. Net design and development efforts are based on a combination of factors. These factors are fish biology and behavior, depth of operation, resource conservation objectives, the operational and handling requirements of the gear, weather conditions, the availability of gear materials, as well as ecological and economic considerations. Model testing is increasingly used for design evaluation and optimization of the existing commercial fishing gear designs, and for development of improved designs. Design drawing of the fishing gear provides all pertinent information relating to their size, shape, material, and construction using recognized nomenclature and symbols in order to permit the construction of identical fishing gears from the same drawing. Each netting panel used in the construction of fishing gear can be derived from one or more sections of particular geometric shapes, such as triangle, trapezium, or rectangle, each of uniform mesh size and twine specifications. This is done by shape-cutting the pieces from the machine-made netting according to pre-calculated taper ratios. The cutting rates used for shape cutting are estimated either by calculation or by using ready-made tables developed for the purpose. Three types of cuts, T-cut, N-cut, and B-cut, and their combinations are used to shape the netting. Panels are fabricated by joining the constituent pieces. The panels are seamed together to assemble the gear. The process of hanging determines the actual shape of a mesh or netting panel. The netting is attached to a rope frame according to a predetermined hanging ratio. After the fishing net is fully assembled, it is rigged with floats and sinkers and accessories such as otter boards in order to make it fully operational. Until the advent of synthetic fibers, natural fibers, which were in common use in earlier years, were preserved by processes such as tanning in order to increase their service life. Even modern fishing nets are subject to wear and tear during their operations. When exposed to direct sunlight for long durations, synthetic materials tend to lose their strength properties. Routine repair and maintenance are required to prolong the life and effectiveness of the fishing nets. After fishing, the gilled and entangled fish are removed and the net is cleaned in water. Torn and damaged netting is repaired by mending the torn parts and replacing the damaged panel sections. To mend a damaged fishing net, the first step is to cut out a proper hole. Cutting the hole removes the damaged netting and prepares the knots on the remaining netting to accept the new twine. Fishing season, the nets are cleaned in fresh water, dried, bundled, and stowed, protected from direct sunlight and natural elements. Metal appurtenances and accessories are cleaned, greased, or painted, and stowed separately. The focus of the Central Institute of Fisheries Technology in recent years has been on promoting responsible fishing by developing selective, eco-friendly, and energy-efficient fishing nets. The fishing industry in India is now reaping the benefits of these developments in terms of better productivity and economic returns.